laptop in there. We're good.
When I was like floor to ceiling screen.
Yeah.
Right.
There's like no other creative, you know, I'm doing the term rapper and all that, so no creative that pays this level of attention to detail. You know, it's not like, ever. And I don't think you can find it. It's really difficult unless, like, you know, you made that the norm of my life.
See this, and I talk to people all the time, like, what's the 22nd century gonna look like?
Wow. But that's what we have to say.
Minimalism.
Yeah.
It's like the best form of design.
Well, I say essentialism. I need to show you the bathroom. Just the first person you can see.
I want to take my ideas to start helping the world. My conversation is we're going to go world problems one by one by one. Research, AIDS research, figuring out medications that are silver bullets. That means ones that treat the problem with the least amount of side effects. Mental health, education. And the way people deal with people with mental health, creating facilities where how about some fucking fresh air instead of 10 pills? You know, one by one, you're gonna soup this motherfucker up. We need the best architects. This shit is ghetto. It's just fucking bootleg. This fucking Ferrari needs a shop.
Interesting. I am working with my architect, Claudio Silvestri. If you have more information on architects that we should work with to build the city, because in Liberia, I envision building a city of the future, an infinite city that can constantly grow. And I envision flying cars. I envision mastering our own minds and telepathic abilities. I envision a spiritual telephone where we can pick up the phone and talk to our ancestors, eventually starting with a Morse code to a language to hearing their voice to eventually seeing them.
Yeah. Got it. Yeah. Cool, yeah. Well, I think it's great to continue to just make things happen. What is your goal? What is your goal? Like, what do you envision of seeing? Like, the house is where you want it to be.
My goal is to have this done in a month.
Wow.
All right.
That's great, man. That's great.
Hi, guys. I'm just going to go to the back because I need to stay on the phone. I love you guys. Thank you.
Love you too, Kanye.
Hey, guys, let's go to the back and draw less attention. You know, we stopped using the term stink because we know and we feel. What I'm doing is highlighting all the positive words in a dictionary and basically making a drum machine of language. How many Africans do you know that became millionaires or billionaires off of an orchestra? Right? None. How many Africans do you know that came millionaires or billionaires off of a drum machine? Right? Because we speak in a simpler language because we don't need the confusion. The future will be simplified.
Yeah.
So
God bless you. Thank you, brother.
Bye-bye. I definitely burned a lot of fucking energy and didn't get the energy back. As soon as I hit Chicago, I came back to life. The music came back to life. That's one of the reasons I'm back in Chicago now.
In abundance, love is the new money. I'm mentally wealthy, spiritually conscious. I'm fresh out of onyx. I'm ballin'. I play with the hunnids. Love is the new money.
I wanted to say I don't have Dropbox, but because I'm no longer using don't, I wrote I need to get Dropbox. Remove the word get. I need Dropbox. Simple. Simplify language to parables. Positive affirmations.
Love is the new money.
Turn that up. We got love. Come on, Jack. What are we doing? We need to work on that language. Yo, Chance, we need to work on that simplified language. Just for us to spend like just a solid hour on that concept and then rap in that, in those parables. That's the beginning of something.
Kanye, you good?
Yes.
You planning?
You planning what?
You planning?
Planning what?
The trip.
All the Africa
trip? Yeah.
Yes, we are.
Okay.
Awesome. Today was awesome. How you feel?
Yeah. I'm still processing. Yeah.
A
lot of intake, right? That's how I just got it.
Yeah, tell me. No.
Yeah.
Like, what do I have to say? No. No, 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 no. Why? And why? No, and why? So I say. I want to know why.
It's okay, from the vintage.
No. Okay, cool. So, you say, but that's why I think we just need to be.
Yeah.
I think that we need to be like teams like this, also very sharp, very clear, very focused, very. The racks, even like for this presentation right here, this rack needs to be way more clear, like it's too bunched in and shit. The reason we started fresh, Chicago, this, that, very focused, very high level, soulful, fresh as fuck, not corny whatsoever, individuals who understand the vision, love, respect the vision, but now you guys got to put your fucking foot down and say, this is what we need in order to be able to do this vision. We're not in Calabasas no more. This is a place we have 80 factories out here. We have workwear factories that will make it. But guys, pull it together. Put your foot down. Speak up. Write it out. This is what we need. Like, we have to get it. Well, I give you guys tomorrow.
All right. Have a good night.
And I'm not going to go. But, okay, I can tell you guys the address.
This is an industry town. I grew up like passing all these factories my whole life and shit. Now it's like we're gonna bring some factories here. Take over some. I got work to do. I got a calling and I'm clear. And the thing is, it's cool, it's friends, y'all care about me, but it's Noah time. Like, you could believe in the story or not, but when he made the ark, he had to make the fucking ark. So I ain't doing nothing that I ain't supposed to be doing. And the universe is on our side. I know it's slightly in James Brown meets Steve Jobs territory, but it is.
Can I help you?
It's not easy. How are you?
How are you, John? Good to meet you.
Good to meet you.
Hello, everybody.
Hi. So John is vice president of the company, and I'm sorry, I didn't want to interrupt you, but he probably should hear.
You know, I'm just going to say some really extreme things to you to let you know exactly where my mind is. So we're doing a car factory, but what kind of cars do you think we're doing? And if I said it's extreme, and I'm good friends with Elon Musk, so what kind of cars do you think we're doing?
Hopefully ones that go...
We're doing the first flying car factory in Chicago. But this is the fire. Real is the new luxury. Working class. I don't like the word class. I just like all. But this, you know, sweatshirts, school uniforms, t-shirts, real functional wear, simplified, not all this Baroque detailing. Oh, yeah.
This is a three-dimensional woven product. There's a company called Adjaye, they have a patent on it. So it just gives it a unique drapeability when it's three-dimensional knit instead of a real flat woven.
Do you want to remember GPA associates are against, respect our guests' privacy?
So they're paying a lot of money for a jacket. This one has a silicone on it, so it's water repellent.
I love it.
Thank you very much. Nice to meet you.
I believe that we bring a beautiful layout of, you know, lovely America, make America great in this thing, right? It's just like you started in his language, so it's like a really nice layout of America. It's got like his logo on the top in red. So we meet the people where they're at. And then you open it up. And you have all this thing that goes into specific categories. You go to workforce, you go into environment, you go into gangs, you go into prison, and like you can lay out all this right here. All these arms, I like the word arms better than segments of division, all these arms that create the ecosystem of what America is. And then talk about, you know, jobs going up, or immediate thing that we're doing with Adidas is bringing factories here. We have to look at ourselves as one family. And the design, this school can bring the glue of that. From education to this prison system. You know, one of the major points I'll show them is that in the 80s and 90s, there's a spike in the prison system because they got rid of the mental health facilities. So actually, we need to turn the prison systems to therapy, where people, it takes a stigma of, oh, you're in prison, we can't hire you, to you're in prison, you're as fucking dope as, you know, a girl from Israel or something. Because, you know, they'll kick your ass and they fucking
get skills.
Yeah, then make sure that these people come back into an enhanced society, because we're not looking to make Mad Max or make some rogue thing. We're looking to turn this motherfucker sci-fi and present those ideas that we can try, or we can put experiment. For me, it's not experiment. I see this as maybe this is not helpful for the meeting, but I'm just gonna go to the extreme. I see myself as being Noah in a different life. And I see this and what I'm pulling together as an arc.
I don't want to face my I don't want to face my
It's all about like not giving up. Nothing's scary to me. I'm not scared. Whatever got coming, it's coming. Make electric drone planes. Silent drone transportation. Everyone that I rapped with in Chicago, some people got record deals, some people couldn't get record deals, blah, blah. And all the shit basically sounded good, and then Jay-Z would come out and crush everybody, right? And what I needed to do is basically become good or better than Jay-Z.
which is what I did.
Yes.
So now in business, it's like this person business, blah, blah. So what I have to do is become Warren Buffett, which is what I'm doing.
Yeah.
About 5 o'clock.
Okay. I think we could leave.
Okay.
Okay.
Should we do the tour?
Okay.
I just looked at your watch and maybe the guy.
Look at it. Has the floor plan is remindful of a medieval classic. So, you know, this cross and at the same time it's round, but it connects different forms. Like an amalgamation of different forms.
The idea that you come right into the center, and from the center you can get to everything.
That's the vibe, I think.
This is a building we've done early on. This is actually a signal box. It's like a huge computer.
This is so beautiful.
You can see that there's this game with geometry is happening at the edge. So the pillars start to dance as the more they turn left or right. This is the steepest concert hall in the world because I'm very much into soccer, and I like in soccer that people make the music, or they are more important than the architecture. People go up very high, they sort of surround the music, the performance, and we even this mushroom has an acoustic function. We even wanted to make this accessible for people who would lie on their stomach and watch the space from here. But that was not allowed. But this is now, as a mushroom goes up and down and creates different kind of acoustic conditions. This would be amazing for you to perform in this space. That could be amazing. Whenever you see something that you find interesting. But we've experimented with so many things.
Yo, Jack, this is a house. I need to live in this thing right here.
Okay. Architecture doesn't have these traditional limits anymore. As much as I still like this house, I can also like or do things which are totally organic or different from what we've seen before. I don't care so much because I think whatever you do, it has to be right in what it is, and doesn't. I don't want to make a hierarchy of this is nice, this is not nice. There are so many, even this normal material, wood can be fantastic and very timeless and contemporary. This is Miami. It has a kind of a dancing structure, a very naked structure.
I love when buildings are being worked on and they have the fabric in front. You know, couldn't we use that fabric as the actual facade?
You would need to replace it after a while.
Okay. Oh no, I have to walk up each and every one of these. Okay. It's not my personality too.
This is in New York, the Armory building for which we do the renovation job. This is something I would love to see one day.
I wish some of our dreams come true.
Let me add to that toast. And it is so. No longer dreams, now reality.
Tap, tap. We're here to change the earth. We're here to care. I believe that your work is that can land and change everything. We have the hands where we can instantly fucking bring the earth to life. Elon Musk is working on a city. Michael Heiser worked on a fucking city. Go city by city. Fuck a building. I mean, we could do a building too. It's cool. It's whatever. It's like, do all of it.
This is my conviction that when you want to grasp everything at the time, it's like eating huge platters. You cannot eat it all together. You go step by step and look at each after the other.
But I'm saying we have the resources. I'm at that castle. They said that was done in 4 years. And Claudio made a joke. He's like, there was a lot of slaves. Well, it's a lot of slaves right now, bro.
Are you interested in politics?
Yes. 2024, I'm president.
Okay.
Why did I have to be dressed like a Sesame Street character for this part of the movie, though? This is really fucking iconic, bro. I'm fucking dressed like Oscar the Grouch and shit.
Let's walk this way. It's 5 minutes from here. I can still smash. I can still smash this. The hell of the day, it's just like a promised it. I look like trash that I still the grouse strip. I can't wait to do song just like a pile of shit. Woo! I look like trash that Oscar the Grouch dressed. Woo! I look like shit. Woo! I look like shit. Woo!
I think it's very important to work on rich and poor at the same time. Exactly. Because the rich is very experimental. You can try things, you have exactly. funding. Exactly. The poor is very necessary. People need it. Exactly. And it's very important not to just get caught up to exactly. either.
I think in the poor it's architectural could be like shelter in the most basic way, but we should make sure we define some kind of program which, let's say, delivers food or health, whatever. Something that is like a spot, you know, that could grow and could be easy accessible for everybody.
That people can make their own food there, farms and aquaponics and may create new industry. The best form of charity, second highest, is creating industry.
These are all possible models, and we certainly would look in all these possibilities, you know, so we can bring in our staff and do it in a way that we don't lose energy, none of us, but we can focus on those two things.
Everybody in here.
These are these five architectural projects that relate to this. The first is the stage.
So basically, like Truman Show meets QVC. So the idea would be like we design the entire neighborhood, but design all the products in it.
I love it, the hotel, like how close our family is and stuff. It's like north is like way closer, now up the stairs and stuff. I just think I want to work on a community idea with you guys that would be like, what's the version? And I understand that you're like younger and you have your life and you might not want to be in the community. And
blah, blah, blah. Within our community, like our own festival at all times.
I did a 7 o'clock just now.
Come on, yeah.
But I didn't eat those damn tacos.
Don't feel bad about that shit,
boy. Yeah, and also the fucking the McDonald's joint. Yeah, earlier.
That one, like I said, we'll forget about that.
But yeah, we just gotta keep getting crews of people that are like, you know, just get this shit done and are on it, and we don't sit on our hands and just imagine just what are the amounts of shit that we can get done today that might take someone else 10 years.
I agree.
I'm gonna text with Big U too, so let's circle around and let's land that shit.
After this. Yep. Perfect. I'll see you for the workout.
Okay, cool, peace. This whole book is so dope. It's like this guy who's designing all these like utopian cities, and it's just page after page of utopian city. The universe is just so crazy. Like, I don't even really know who it came from. Like, who is Dennis R? Like, Dennis, I know Dennis Robin, they give me this.
It's beautiful.
Oh, it's Dennis Roach?
May I come in?
Yes.
Good morning.
Hey, what's up, it's Jay. How are you?
I'm good, how are you? You changed your number again.
Yeah, it's gonna keep happening. The, I had to keep on eliminating these Corey Gamble CIA types.
Oh my gosh.
That's not some paranoid shit.
Did Corey say he was part of the CIA at one point? Or am I making that up?
So Nico, are you from LA originally?
From Orange County.
Oh. Yeah, I like it out of Orange County. Hey, babe, I just sent you this address. I'm like in the middle of Hollywood and I like don't have no security with me and I'm just tripping for that. You know?
Where are you going? Okay, you want me to send someone?
Yeah, or someone or a couple people and shit and just make sure.
Okay, doing that right now.
Okay, thanks. Right.
Okay, bye.
Yeah. What's good? Yo. You got any hand lotion?
Yeah, I'm sure they got some in here.
All right, thanks.
Yeah,
I'm at this shoot, so we can have another discussion about this. I think the big thing is everybody want to go to Adidas, but nobody wants to fix what I'm dealing with and really get me free of these arrangements.
It's like Paterno, I don't fuck with Paterno. He's like, I don't fuck with him, man. I just think everybody be capping. And like the, just even like with the publishing deal, I was like, oh man, you know, you, this shit is just, it's all cap, bro. It's all cap. And it's like, niggas gotta get me out, bro. And it's like, and nothing better than that happened to me, and I need to get out. And also, Scooter, as far as your percentage go, it's eat what you kill. You don't get 10% of everything. You said that to Lester. We never had that conversation. It's eat what you kill, period. I don't want nothing that look like Elvis. He stole. That's how I was talking to fake Elvises right now. Give me an African pose.
An African pose?
Fuck I'ma do, I'm yay, show, posing show. Like fucking Elvis. Show me. Fucking Elvis. Y'all get the exact feeling from that phone call in the photos.
Whatever it's called. Good.
Scott was saying the same thing when it was getting to that point, you know?
Daddy,
yeah.
Why do you always get on
the phone calls? Hey, Fanaz, Norvaz, where I was always on the call. I'm about to get off the phone. I'll call you. Was a tent and a cardboard?
Yeah.
That's like, that might be a homeless person, Northy.
about to die because it's like
gradual.
Yeah, gradual, bruh. Keep shit gradual.
That note.
And y'all the ones who make a part of
that.
I wasn't expecting that.
He really
I love those. You know, I sit in the studio and just like vibe out always. We are the ones who make a part.
That's the best part of the song.
But he did those notes. I have a song on my new album that I wrote with Carol Bayer Sega, who wrote this song, called The Garden. And we're gonna and that's the purpose, is to turn the earth to the garden. And we're gonna perform the song this Sunday.
What are you doing now?
We do it at a rehearsal space in Burbank. We're at the rehearsal space until we get your space. I should just sit with you and just tell you other ideas we're doing, but James Turrell is here today on my 300 acre property, and I'm getting into building communities like Mike Melman.
Yeah.
And building things that last and that stay there. And with my music, as you saw, I'm getting into making healing music. So not so much pop music. And if it's pop, it's cool. Like you get like a smash, but the purpose isn't just to get the next hit single, but it's to like build things that will help people. So I just need to be in a position to be like, to be able to help people, to be able to make, if there's money I need to make to do it, but eventually I don't want to have to use money. I just want to be able to use my mind and creativity and say, okay, let's redo this park, or let's redo the menu for the school, or let's make Yeezy free so it's like kids clothes and school clothes. Let's make, you know, let's get into finding a medication, an AIDS cure, you know, that we can bring to Africa. Let's find out how we can plant our neighborhoods in a way that we could be self-sustaining and bring that to Haiti and DR. And, you know, it's a big plan that we're putting together. Actually, I'm gonna put it together over the next few days and I can show it to you later this week.
So how do you lay it out when you think about it? What would you like where?
There is 16 acres of buildable, so to say, space. But we could do whatever we want on the landscape. So anything that's unconditioned, we could put like, and basically build like this anthill, you know, world. And this is just the very tip of the property. And it'd be good to like look that way, but then it's another one of your structures right there. So we're looking at just nature. Only things I want to see is nature and Terrell.
There's been a lot of change in my life. Some might have guessed that, some had to find. Must keep the faith in within each other. You are my brother.
That goes a little bit higher, just to put like the things a little bit higher, so you can
take out that for instance, all of that there.
Yeah,
very easily.
People have some pretty expensive homes up here, so I'd like to show them the, like that Michael Jackson song said, let me show you the way to go. I'd like to show them the way to go, or show them what we're doing, and if they're interested in going into the future.
Yeah, I think it's the proportions and the space and the idea of how to approach
you know, where a learning center, a church,
yes,
where we sleep, where we dwell, indoor, outdoor space, a medical facility, a mental health facility.
I think this is one of the more successful ones. So it's the creator, where you have dwelling units around, each one with a sleeping space, a bathroom, and a closet. Mm-hmm. And then underneath in the middle would be the shared spaces, living, eating, dining.
It has to look like it has great ease and it's effortless, but at the same time, you know how much work it is. Mm-hmm. And you know how much work it is for you to do them, too, and how tired you get after them. Or sometimes you just feel completely wiped out.
It's all the years they're going to.
Yeah.
In order to do that church, it's like, you know, I did it, I put it together in 7 days, the choir.
Yes.
But it wasn't 7 days, it was 41 years. 7 days.
Absolutely, yes. <Yeah. laughs>
Like the process of it.
To these, let's see what it means for these couple houses that are over here too.
Yeah.
Giant playground, basically. What was the idea of like communal, like kibbutz?
No, I'm just trying to understand. Yeah. I didn't realize it was so big. Okay, so you would like a proposal taking consideration of all this. Let's call it functional. Sorry to bother you. Did you work out the square feet of this? Just to give a general.
If we take
the square foot of this right here.
The church?
Yeah. It's about 500.
Stokes Canyon is the V1, the demo tape of the frontier generation, and we are the guinea pigs. Stokes Canyon is the community of the future. A template of a new aesthetic, a new functionality, and a new way of life for the entire universe. A way of life that we couldn't imagine, nor knew we needed. Stokes Canyon is an end-to-end, self-sufficient, sustainable paradise, 22nd century Arcadia, our Eden. A family-oriented community where a three-year-old can be by themselves and be safe.
Look, it's like, look at Max Lamb and our architect, Zach, and the people carrying this fucking foam sheet. Look at them.
Look at them, they're fucking smacking their shit. Let's walk over there where they're at. Okay.
Right?
Yeah, looks like you're having a good time walking across the street with those.
Tom.
Bobby.
Yeah, I was really into this idea, these kind of. This kind of thing. Mm-hmm. This would be like. This is standing, this isn't over, this is like. A standing shot, you know what I mean? Like, to have like a groove that's like the bottom of the room is here, you know what I mean? To be like up. You think about the community, and it's like 300 acres and 10,000 square, 20,000 foot spaces. I don't use the word square anymore. Foot spaces. This, you know, making it, and also making it something where like my 3-year-old son could be all the way up there, but like it's just a slide and it's that and blah blah. Like whenever you have like lost spaces, people are always making things like this. You always got like these stairs and always feels like a little bit dangerous.
Soft floors, soft walls, soft homes.
So this is the idea, like this is actual floors and then sleeping bags and pillows are your thing, and then like
everything soft and you can just be. Mm-hmm.
Like when you get into the soft rooms, the whole room is like soft, and so we're building examples of that.
Living becomes play. Life becomes play.
You can even have a room that's only a bath. I think it should be an even smaller circle for that type of concept. If we can think about the bath.
A man-made, a yay-made wonderland planted on the rolling hills of Calabasas, built using primitive technologies and indigenous materials. Raw material extracted from the estate becomes architecture. Quarried stone, rammed earth, aggregated concrete. Landscape and architecture are indistinguishable.
Hey, you think this is enough room for a dual closet?
Thanks. What I found was really important in a closet is like the stylist is always in there and needs scissors, needle, thread, tape, like lint things. Like there has to be a little drawer or something for like all the essentials.
This thing like here could be like, you know, higher, right? But like a floating mirror. It doesn't have to be like on the wall. There could be versions of, and it could be like a three-way mirror or something like that. And just, if you got, you know, all this space in one thing. I like how it's like these objects, like this is like, you put drinks on this, and it's like this, and pictures of being higher.
Yeah,
makes me think about mutual air space.
My last house, I built my glam room upstairs, and I built stairs. I know we're not doing stairs, but like it was so inconvenient for them to bring their heavy bags up. So this is so much easier, but then they get in, I would love like a little coffee machine, you know, there's a bathroom. I would love a little, you know, we spend about sometimes 5 hours a day there, you know, especially if we have a shoot tomorrow. So it's going to be, you know, in and out. And today, like for an award show, it's like a 3 or 4 hour glam, you know, there's always so much going on. But I love that, the kids can come in and always hang out with me, sit on the little couch if they want. I would say our two biggest areas are kitchen floor, like traffic, and it's going to be like kid and glam group. Because no one like respects your stuff and your space, really. This looks so cool.
This room goes all the way around, so you can walk all the way around. This is the basin. It's kind of completely circular room.
And so there'll be space for all my products and stuff and drawers, like under here.
Shelving, yeah.
As long as I don't have drawers, because I have all my products.
And there's stuff. Yep.
Toothbrush.
We need to engineer how those drawers work, or how drawers work when they're in round.
It's gonna change how the products we use in these environments are probably gonna be designed.
I love it.
One of the things that now I really see and everyone sees, I'm so interested in architecture, I will travel to Japan to just look at something in real life. When I'm in Japan, I get super inspired and people are treating me like an actual human being. Not less than, not greater than. For the most part, it's just like a general respect.
And the Lord said, Moses, depart and go up hence thou and the people which thou hast brought up out of the land of Egypt unto the land which I swear unto Abraham, to Isaac, and to Jacob, saying, unto the seed I will give it, and I will send an angel before thee, and I will drive out the Canaanite, the Amorite, the Hittite, and the Perizzite, and the Hivite, and the Jebusite.
Vision is my strongest gift, even though his talent is like whatever, it's like, but to have the vision to be like, I'm going to make, like, I was making video games in seventh grade, and the video game to program the people and to draw each one of these, which I was doing, and programming, that was way harder and less, and it didn't feed my soul like when I was doing the music part. So in seventh grade, I made the decision, had the vision to do the music.
I will come unto the midst of thee in a moment and
put off thy ornaments from thee, that I might know.
I always could draw. I got to went to college on an art scholarship and still had the wherewithal. I was looking at my paintings and I was like, it ain't Picasso level. I'm just working at an advertising agency or something like that. Let me keep driving this idea of music because I must be getting better. I mean, R. Kelly almost bought a beat from me and, you know, I sold his beat to this local artist and blah, 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 and just having that vision. So since I have that vision, if people are coming to me and saying, well, yeah, I want to see what you see, that I will share with you what I see.
Hey, hello. Hi, how are you?
Nice to see you.
Good to see you too. Hello. Hello, what's up?
Yeah, thank you for coming.
This is very cool. Do you have some things to show us?
Yes. I want to show you the opera house in Taiwan.
With this shape, actually, it deflects the sound very well.
This is a small museum, my house in Tokyo. Can I take a picture with you?
Yes, please.
To smile.
Smile.
This wasn't here last time.
Yeah, they developed them.
This is great. Yeah, this wasn't here. Yeah, this is fire. This wasn't here either. This is fire. Oh, they bought a whole different rack. Yeah, this shit wasn't here. This is such a random color. This is sick.
But do you not like this color? Because I feel like the Yeezy version of the color would be that. Like it wouldn't be
I like this, yeah. But I have to be in the mood for it. Like that spearmint, like I have to be in the mood. Like I could always kind of go for that. I'm always going for this. And then this will be third, but this, I even like this. What this is almost doing.
Mm-hmm. The whole space is furniture.
Yeah. And if this is very in line with the shoe. Mm-hmm.
What's this?
That was like, it's a light.
See the shoes in this space?
Running around, and, you know. So that's I love when I can. If I'm even more ramped up, I really tap into like 5-year-old, 4-year-old, 3-year-old sensibility. Yeah. And sometimes I'll look back, like after I like come down, I'm like really calm, and I look at the ideas. And that was the idea right there. I had it right there. Yeah. But that's the whole. The problem is you have all the answers when you're ramped up, but no one wants to listen to you. Cause it'll just be like too much information for people and this and that. Like you go back and you take like when I met with Trump and just take every line one by one, it all is actually the exact thing that should be said. It was just like,
yeah.
The people like, I just didn't understand.
Yeah. And it's, you know what, it's like you just said, you know, you like people want you to grow up to somebody else, an actuality, somebody else. Yeah, the machines always just be you. You feel me? Whatever you want to do. You get out from the set. That's what makes you live forever. Because it's the thing, man. Everybody wants to be young.
All I do is like read the Bible and then make things. I say, like, there's nothing, there's very little things that are man made that are better
than what I actually had in my head. And it's only a few times, like, you know, that something that's man-made can, like, even, like, match something. Only, like, when God made is better than what I can think of, like, I'm just sitting looking at a caterpillar, like, four butterflies came, and I just, like, stare at him for, like, really, like, 4 or 5 minutes, just staring at him walking and stuff, and just imagine it. But when I make it, like, if God come in, like, one creature and just body this whole thing, like, just one instant. Like, as much as we're looking into this, so that's the thing, that whenever something feels more organic or more, you know, alien or more like an insect or an animal or something like that, that's one of the things I love about this print. It feels more like,
wow,
yeah, you know, that kind of.
This looks like the refrigerator room kitchen of the future.
Yeah.
But totally elegant, just really like, I feel like it's one thing to have like a Da Vinci sketch of an airplane, it's another thing to be like the Wright brothers. And I feel like there's some things, a lot of references that we look at that are really like Teletubby, and then it's like the Turrell and Stephen Pike stuff feels like Wright brothers. I feel like it's gonna fly. Yeah.
The idea like that over there in 72, that little foam thing you sit in, I mean, that could be a toilet and a bathtub and a shower and a couch and a seating room and a bit, you know? It was so interesting. Like, so we're looking at all these shoes and they're coming out so good and everything. You got like the 350 V3 and it has this 8-inch print on it. You got the 3D printed shoe, has a really good vibe to it. We looked at them all in the foam room yesterday. And I take the Turrell things that I was very cautious about when I got them, because it was like the Lord of the Rings. I was like, this is the answer. How we're talking about how we build things out of foam. Let's build the big Turrell space in 4 months.
Should the whole thing, the whole city, is on?
Yeah, I guess you try. I mean, eventually will be. It's gotta be, you know, this would be like a new standard. This idea, this kind of space. And then people will look at the thing, we're gonna start making couches like that, so we might as well be the ones to do it also. What's the foam modular version of that?
He feels that should be. Did you lie on this one? That was like a little bit longer.
Yeah. When it was more reclined back, it was at this length.
Could you lay on this one right now? This one's more.
Or else it's 3.6.
But see, shelter, this is like the exact thing that I would want for my home. After, you know, have Axel or anything, so, but this is so homeless shelter, this is orphanage, like those are like beds right there.
Same time as building out that over there,
yeah,
you have
like I feel joy when I come into the space and I hear how I sound, you know, from my voices and that it resonates, then taste is this artificial version of joy. It's something agreed upon that was programmed to us, you know, as opposed to like, you know, we didn't know, we didn't plan that this thing would, you know, do this kind of sound like that. So how can we make it more scientific? What do you need to live? Because I feel like there's a fear in people not accepting what we are presenting. So we want to put it in easy tones. And, you know, I'm so sick of like the taste conversation. So, you know, how do we get to the more just into the study of like actual needs and living?
I can show you the helicopter property of Polaris. John,
yes.
Would you like to get on the Polaris?
Think of the heated slab where you've got
Like a radiant
your radiant
line.
Lines, but I now you're running water. You're running cool water through.
That's beautiful, yeah.
Instead of radiant tubes, it's chilled tubes.
Yeah.
Okay. Cast in the slab.
You just look at it online.
Yeah, I've never done it, but it's not, I mean,
same concept as radiant flooring.
It's exactly the same. Just the reverse.
You're running a chilled water line versus a heated water line.
Yeah. Just think the thing is, in those caves, you're gonna need because the temperature will stay stable and a hot temperature if you don't cool it down.
And in the summer, we'll wish we had a chill summer.
You really will wish.
I'll share that right now.
Yeah.
Try and find it.
What would be the most inexpensive way to best
gravel? I'll compact it with dense gravel.
Jalil, I said the word.
sketches, the Turrell sketches.
So this piece of this art is we thought it was at the last Tokyo, and it's all in the store. And then we sketched this,
but I'm feeling his breath on my neck.
They said they had these two mice, and one was on a flat surface and one was on this kind of slope. And of course, the mouse that was on the slope, his brain would end up being 15% bigger because it was things connected through all of his limbs that actually help you develop. You know, even like, you know, our feet not supposed to be shaped like this. Like by the time we get older, they're supposed to start like, yeah. So it's all kind of examples where we put ourselves into boxes. One of the best things about Sunday service is just that people feel more comfortable. Like, oh man, I actually love Jesus, man. I forgot about this. I grew up
with
this.
That's a fact. Yeah. That's a fact. I ain't gonna lie, that shit touched me. I was saying, man, I was telling someone that I'm going to church. Yeah. I feel like every song was pertaining to the situation.
day we're gonna need backup. Entering the atmosphere. Make way for a crash land. 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 Make way for a crash land.
Make way
for a crash land. This time you won't understand it. One day you won't understand it. Got something like a juice stand. So I said we set new standards. We gon' call ourselves humanities. So we gotta sign up with the dude stand. So we won't long to the self-invested. And we'll stop wanting the extraterrestrial. We don't need an interstellar travel. We just need an edit set of atoms. We just need to go ahead and battle. Different languages have gone babble. Father, I don't understand it. Hold on, what is all then?
Hold up!
Don't sound, we get something then. We gon' run, we gon' suffer from famine.
You know, our mission for coming here is to work with Axel to design these spaces for the Bahamas, which have to be hurricane proof. So they have to be underground, which is like what I've been working on the whole time. You know, anyway.
I just would like to show you here.
Concept is everything green as it is, so we did it with the walls with him, and then we painted it with Japanese ink. The idea where east and west comes together.
We have, I think we have all lunch in the castle, is it okay?
Yes. This is, you know, I wanted plants here, but it's the roof terrace, there's a garage underneath. So we're just putting the plants like you transport.
It's like a bonsai.
It's like a bonsai.
Oh.
Rick Fox is the head of the Bahama Relief Foundation. Could you explain a little bit about what's happening with the disasters?
Yeah, so Hurricane Dorian, as you know, just has come through the country and has devastated two of our main islands. It has displaced 70,000 people. The need for housing and homes is immediate. Mm-hmm. So I appreciate you just even considering this. Kanye, thank you, and Axel.
To make what nature destroyed, but using it again for architecture, and, and it's very healthy as well. And it's, I think it's very important. You think globally, but you act very locally. First of all, thank you all for coming that far. I feel very honored and humbled that you did all this effort.
So I need to be very, very useful. So I think we have, after everything we discussed, there's a lot of, there's always the same things we love together. The purity, and I think of the community we would like to create, there should be a purity. But I think a purity in color, in all shades of the color of the local earth, and the shapes based on sacred proportions. But they can be square and they can be round, and I think there should be an enormous variety, like in a real town, a real village, not all the same, like a communist, whatever, everybody should live the same. I think it's so important that everybody can live the way he wants to live. I think we have to find a solution to make a lot of difference, but unity in the difference. And the unity will be, it's part of the local situation, it's based on sacred proportions, and then inside they can do what, and then the house will always stay, we make something that's gonna be there in 300 years still. What do you think of that?
Yes.
Okay, let's start. Let's make people happy. That's the most important. I think that's the biggest purpose of everything we're gonna do is make people happy.
Drop that. Drop them a dime.